Hello, this is my sister here, and this is my sister now. My sister asked me to do a cute little style on her, so this is where I'll be doing her style. This is where I usually do family members' hair. But my sister has to have hair and other hair supplies for her to get the style that she wants. So she can't magically say, "Naya, do my hair," without any hair supplies. So let's go ahead and go get that now. So this is the beauty supply store where all the supply will be. Honestly, this is my favorite place. This is like Candyland to me. These are butterfly locks. My sister loved these two colors. It was so hard trying not to buy something I don't need in that store, but now we can get back to doing my sister's hair and I can show you what I use to do her hair with. So we have the gel, the jam, the mousse, the rubber bands, the oil, the hair, and we have clips, crochet needle, combs, all types of combs, and barrettes. Everything we need on this sink is what we need for my sister's hair. But these are the most important products. That is my sister's hair natural and the curls. This is my sister's hair stretched out. You're probably wondering how her hair got like that, and that's a process called blow drying. It stretches the hair. What you see here is me putting jam on her scalp, and that's for me to easily part her scalp and make it even and look perfect as possible. Now I'm putting oil on her hair to keep it moisturized. Next, I'm going to split that section and make a box and add a rubber band to form a braid. And I'm not going to do it too tight. I'm going to make it just right where she's comfortable. I will then keep making boxes out of those sections and making those boxes into braids by using rubber bands, and I'm gonna make sure I don't do them too tight all over her head. So this is how the braids turned out, and this is how they're gonna look all over her head. Next, I'm gonna use the red toothbrush and the purple jar. You're probably wondering why I'm using a toothbrush for hair, and that's because baby hairs are very small, and you can't use a regular size brush, so the toothbrush is what makes the baby hairs more smoother and prettier. I wanted to add that the toothbrush has never been used, it was bought, and I just wanted to show another clip of how I put rubber bands on the hair and braid the hair a little bit more closer. So this is my sister's final look for her natural and real hair. Her hair is parted neatly in the rubber bands and braided neatly, perfectly, and clean. So this next part is probably the hardest part of doing this style. So what you see here is me using a crochet needle to hook the false hair or the lock through her real hair so that the real hair can go through the false hair. So I'm inserting the crochet needle through the lock, and once I insert it through the top of the lock, I grab the real hair with the hook and put it through the lock. And so now I will continue to do that on that one lock, and I'll do that her entire head. Her hair turned out great, and as you can see, I crocheted the false hair and put the real hair inside the false hair all around her head. You can tell my sister loves this style. It looks beautiful on her, and I'm glad that I could do this style on her, and she loves it.